guys, welcome back. We are going to be looking at week three, our second lesson, lesson 119. And you will need your Bible page 175 and 176. We're going to do both sides today with this lesson. We will get to this in a minute. Today, our story is another application story. Remember, an application story is not a story found in the Bible. It is a fictional or made-up story, but it is a story that can teach us a lesson or gives us something to kind of chew on to think about, and we can think about how we might respond as God would like us to respond. Okay, so today, our story is called The Misery of Sin. All right. As I am reading, I'd like you to listen and think about this question. See if you can figure this out. What were the results of Billy's sin? Okay, so we have a character named Billy in our story. Think about what happened. What was the result of his sin? All right, let's dive right in. Billy was so happy when he woke up on Saturday. He was going biking with his friend Zach. He got dressed, ate breakfast, and went to meet his friend. They rode by Mrs. Hinckley's house. She grew strawberries to sell. Billy and Zach looked at the field of berries turning bright red. Billy said, "We could take a few. Who would miss them?" Zach thought for a while and then shook his head. "No, it's wrong. Even if no one sees it. Besides, somebody will see us. God is always watching. And because I'm a Christian, I'm his servant, and I want to serve him every day in everything that I do." So he's thinking about, no matter if anyone sees it or not, God sees, and I need to be doing the right thing. Billy didn't reply, but the boys kept riding around until almost noon. Remember, noon is 12 o'clock, right in the middle of the day, right? Kind of lunchtime. When Zach left to go home for lunch, Billy went by Mrs. Hinckley's house again. Bright red berries hung on the plants. Billy liked strawberries better than any other fruit. He laid his bike down out of sight and went into the field. He meant to eat only a few berries, but they were so rich and juicy, he just kept eating. Sounds like he couldn't help himself. He just really enjoyed them. When he finally decided to leave, he realized that he had an awful stomach ache. When Billy got home, he went to his room to lay down. Then his mother called him to come for lunch, and he tried to look cheerful. "Did you have a good morning ride with your friend, son?" asked his father.
Yes, sure, answered Billy.
"Where did you go?" asked his mother. Billy felt like he was going to be sick. He managed to say, "Oh, to the bridge and back," his father said. "Did you stop anywhere?" Billy just shook his head no. He thought about the lie he had just told and felt even sicker. Finally, his mother asked him, "Billy, is anything wrong? You've hardly touched your food." Billy hung his head and said, "I'm just tired and not too hungry." Then his mother said, "Well, I have something that will make you feel better in a jiffy." She went into the kitchen and brought out set before him a big heaping dish of strawberry shortcake. Billy's stomach gave a funny jump, and before he could stop himself, tears were running down his face. Why do you think he's crying now? Right now? What do you think is happening? Is he starting to feel something not only in his stomach, but in his heart, right? His mother felt his forehead. "What is wrong, Billy? Are you sick?" Billy nodded. His father got up to help him from the table. "Why, Billy, you should have said something. Let me help you, son." Billy let his father take him to his room. He didn't know which made him feel worse, the stomach ache or deceiving his parents.
"Dad, I have to tell you something." And Billy told what he had done.
"I'm so sorry," his father said. "I am too. When you feel a little better, we'll talk about this." That evening, Billy and his parents talked. He prayed for forgiveness and apologized to his parents. Then he went to Mrs. Hinckley and asked her to forgive him too. When he returned home, he said, "Mrs. Hinckley says if I'm
help her pick berries next week, she'll consider me paid up. Billy gave a huge sigh of relief. With a clear conscience, he slept very well that night. All right, let's go back to that main question at the very beginning. What were the results of Billy's sin? So Billy was being dishonest, right? And he took strawberries from Mrs. Hinkley's garden that did not belong to him, and he didn't ask permission, right? So that made him not only have a stomach ache because he ate so much, but it also made his heart feel bad, right? That's called your conscience, and that's the Holy Spirit telling us right from wrong. So he realized here that he had done something wrong. Okay, so what then happened? He confessed to his parents, right? And he asked for forgiveness. They prayed. And he also went to his neighbor and was honest with her, right? And asked for forgiveness. Okay. All right. So now let's take a look at this page, page 175. And up at the top, it says, Jesus helps us when we are tempted. Jesus was tempted as we are. He can help us turn away from temptation. Now, it's important to note, even though Jesus was tempted by Satan, he still chose to do the right thing. So he never sinned, even though he was tempted. So there are times, like the friend in this story, Billy's friend, was tempted and probably wanted to get some strawberries too. But did he choose to do the right thing or the wrong thing? He chose to do the right thing, right? So he did not sin. However, Billy did sin because he chose to give in to that temptation, right? Okay. So what we're going to do here is find out what God says by reading the Bible verse. Read each of the groups of sentences. Answer the question by coloring yes or no. So here in this column, it has what Satan says for each of these different situations, and then what God's word says. So here you have different Bible verses to look up. Remember, look in your table of contents for where those books of the Bible are. Then you're gonna read the scenario or situation here, then you're gonna circle yes or no, okay? So that's this side. Then turn this page over and it says write a word from the word bank to complete each sentence. You have your word bank in green right here. You have the words follow, anything, example, God, and Savior. So you're going to read each of these different sections, and there's a picture to go along with it too to help you out, maybe give you some clues. The illustrations help to give us clues, right? So answer that using the word bank. Then you're going to use these words from the word bank to find them in the fun little word search down here. All right. So, continue to work on this. I miss you guys. Continue to work on the armor of God. It's important, especially right now, be putting on that armor of God every single day. That helps us when we are tempted, right? And that helps us when we're afraid. We talked about how there are things in life that can be fearful. Put on that armor of God, and that helps us. All right. I love you guys. Till next time. See you later.